Yeah, I just hit 100 diligence just from it.
Nice.
It gave me like 10k. What the hell?
Nice.
I hit 100 diligence just from that pink bean thing. That's hilarious.
That's awesome. Now you can scroll stuff with 2% more chance.
10.
10?
It's 10% more chance.
Oh yeah, I always thought it was 2.
No. I wouldn't do it if it was 2. Hey guys, Amite here, and welcome to another episode of Road to Max Damage in MapleStory, where we try and get max damage with only using Messals. I changed my policy. It's a little bit too wordy. No NX except for using others and blah blah blah. So I'm just gonna call this the Road to Max Damage Messals Only run. So as you're watching this clip, actually, I haven't even started editing the episode before, so I'm like really far behind in terms of like updating you guys with what I'm doing in Maple. But editing is a lot of work, and I just finished uploading Kelvin's gear showcase video. That's basically where I'm at right now, as of right now when you're watching this. So yeah, I have a lot to catch up to, and school starting and whatnot. So school first, guys, stay in school. Anyways, you must be wondering why I am on my Evan, and no, it's not because of the name change event. It's actually October 1st, and it's October 1st, and it's the turn of the month, so that means the reward points shop has restarted. So, you know what that means? I'm gonna be priming my heart. Where did my heart go? Oh, I already put it in my inventory because of the last take. Okay, so let's go to the cash shop. I'm just going to quickly do this. I'm trying to work on a format for these episodes, and I'm going to try and do it this episode, and I'll see how it works. But yeah, so let's get on to priming stuff. I'm so happy protection scrolls are like worth 50 mil right now, so I might even just spend some of the prepaid NX I have. Oops. So, shield scroll, guardian scroll, bot, and yeah, as you can see from here, I actually got about 80k in NX now. $10 was sent to me as a gift from a good friend, Mark, and the rest of them I bought. So thank you, Mark. Shout out to you. And yeah, protection scrolls are like 50 mil now, so I might actually spend some of this, and just, you know, get the rest for miracle time, because really I actually do want to get this heart finished. And since I'm changing the series to like Messals Only, it's more descriptive of, you know, what I'm doing and whatnot. But I'll figure this out in a little bit. I'm probably not going to be recording for a long time because I have a lot of assignments and midterms are about to come up, so I'm just not going to bore you guys. How about that? Okay, so we're done. Let's go somewhere nice to go scroll. My favorite spot to scroll is definitely Ardent Mill. Ardent Mill is my favorite spot because this was where I got my one-hand sword perfected when I really needed it, like inside here in the expert patch. This was where I icogged a lot of my godly stuff, and Skype is going off, god damn it. So yeah, Ardent Mill is my go-to spot for scrolling, and that being said, it was my only place for scrolling, but so I'm just not superstitious. I'm not too superstitious. Alright. Okay, so let us start scrolling. So protection scrolls applied. I have a lucky day on it. That's good. Let's put this. Everything's all good. Superior Lydium Heart. Yes, so upgrade count protected and scroll protected. Alright. You are the most stubborn prime I've had so far, and this month is my month. October is my birthday. Please just pass all of them without fail, I beg of you. Okay, you guys ready? Let's do this. For two-handed weapon. God fucking damn it. All right, let's start this episode off with a little bit of shopping. A while ago, I did say I was never ever going to spend Messals on NX ever again, like Perman X and stuff. And I just can't help it. This item is so, oh, I just want it so badly, and I can afford it. I can afford it. I really want it. So I'm gonna show you guys what it is. Where is it? Okay, here it is. It's this G Clef label ring. So basically, it goes over my IGN, and I get to have you see the little picture down there. I get to have that as my overlay, and this is the only one in FM. It's supposed to be around 1.1, 1.2 bill, but this guy has it up there. But it's the only one, and I've been trying to ask around for it, and I pr with my luck, probably someone, so the rings are probably going to start showing up in FM for some reason, and they're gonna be like super cheaper or like just cheaper in general. But I really want it, and I made some unexpected money, so it's just something I really want. And as much as this series is important to me, I feel like I should be having fun as well. I've talked about this in a previous episode. I don't want to make this clip too long, but basically, yeah, I want to buy it. So there we go. This is going to be the last NX item I'm going to buy for a very long time. With this ring, you guys ready?
No,
Oh.
I'm ready.
Hey, this is gonna. This I love this ring.
Music.
The label ring.
Yeah.
How much was
What's it
that?
called? 1.5.
Really?
Yeah, it's like 1.2, but this was the only one left, and I had no patience whatsoever. But
Have the chat. The
this is,
chat.
yeah, this is so perfect for me though.
Did Z go?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy.
Jun.
June.
All right, so to recap a little bit, we're back at our usual spot to ramble about things, but lots of stuff has happened between episodes because it's been a whole month and I just got busy, school came along, and all these other excuses. Oh yeah, guys, I should show you this really cool trick that you can do with all these teleport glitches in Pantheon right now. So whenever you're bored, you can practice this. So okay, so you gotta get on here. I'll just do this once and show you guys. I love that. If you practice it well enough, you can actually do an end never ending loop of it. So you go here, teleport to this platform, you get to the top of this whatever that is, the town hall or whatever, and then your recoil from dropping, if you do it right, is you'll land right back at the ladder. It's really fun to do, but yeah, this town is so buggy, it's fun. Anyways, so just to recap, guys, my range right now is 712,000 rounded up. Max while buffed, just a rough estimate, so I'll just say like 700 because my pets are always buffing me and whatever. Right now I'm wearing my Dimension Gloves again because I tried to reroll my glove for some more strength or abilities. Where's my glove? Actually, I have a lot of loot right now. It's the weekend, so CRA loot. Give me a second here. Looking for my gloves. Here they are. So, they were 6% strength or something. Yeah, 6% strength, and I lost it. So that's why I still have these dimension gloves in case this ever loses. Another thing that changed is my shield. The potential changed to 9% total damage, but this is only temporary. I'm trying to get it to tier up, and I'm frozen again. And that was a really fast recovery. But my sword. I lost all the cubing clips because I mass deleted all my recordings after I finished with an episode, so the previous episode. So yeah, my bad. So it's a 12% strength and 18% attack. It's not like perfect, but I have three useful lines on it, so I'm just gonna keep it like that for a while. But yeah, other than that, that's all the changes to my equips. So let's get on with the episode. And I know there's a lot of talking in this episode as well, but I wish this was more like a Minecraft commentary like Etho, where he could be doing something interesting while talking, but all I'm good at doing is like jumping around town as I explain stuff. So the structure of my episodes have been a little bit more prominent. I've actually started like writing out templates for scripts of how I want my episode to be like, so this is quite an improvement for me, but I unfortunately am susceptible to change. And I have to add this a little bit here because tonight is Wednesday, and tomorrow's a new patch. It's going to be the Asylum patch. It's going to be the Halloween 2015 patch. And I went through the patch notes, and well, let's just say that my ha I'm going to be busy. Not too busy. I'm just saying. But zombie events back. So free hearts. Loss of characters. So I'm going to suddenly get like, 20 hearts. Doom totems are back, so the these guys, the dark doom totems. I definitely want to put it on at least my Evan or my Night Lord. My Night Lord has one gold and two bronze, and my Evan has nothing, so I definitely want to throw them over there for my other sub mains. And Kana Hayato reworks gonna be interesting. I don't know what to expect, but they're getting reworked, so hip hip hooray. So yeah, with the addition of Mabel stuff I have to do by tomorrow. Well, I guess it's a long time for events, so I'm not going to try and do everything on the first day. I don't think it's even possible to do it on the first day, but but I definitely will be maybe making an episode on that. But for now, like I said, I'm trying to structure my episodes better, plan them better, that type of stuff. So, yeah, onwards with this episode to more interesting things. Ooh, okay. Ooh! So, as I am eagerly waiting for my party members for today's Commercy run, I feel like this episode I should be explaining to you what I plan to do, so you don't go what the fuck every 5 seconds asking what the hell am I doing. So the plan for this episode today is that I will be grinding reward points so that I can prime my heart. Let's see. Oh, my heart's in storage. But basically, I have a good friend who is willing to help me with this grind. And so I have my other account, and I have a second account that my friend has graciously donated to me so that I can grind reward points on his account. And basically, I'm just going to go farm Star Planet like a little bitch. So let's see how that goes. I meant with the scrolling. Okay, I'm ready to do this. I am ready to do this. Let's go, click on it.
Right now?
Yes. Also, I'm recording now. Oh no, I forgot to accept the quest. Did you accept the quest?
Oh, I haven't tried to do that
Shit.
completely.
Shit.
I didn't start a game yet, so it doesn't matter.
I'm lucky. I haven't done this in forever. I swear I'm crazy for doing this on like so many accounts.
Yes.
Which character are you on? I don't see you in the lobby.
I'm going out of this because it's not. How do we get out of here? I want to change channels. Because I can't find anyone here.
Maybe you should have gone in channel one.
Yeah, I don't think there would be there. How do you get out of here? You have to jump.
You have to talk to the bunny.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Oh no, he's gonna change the color. No. Yes, oh my god, oh my god. I won. I won. Yes.
Ah, fuck.
I won,
Was so close to winning, and they had to screw it all over.
Oh, that's a nice healthy amount of points, 113. All right, 6 games done, 4 more to go. Please,
Yep.
please, please, please stick to the cards. Yes. And then yes. Oh my god, 4 victory.
You're going crazy.
Oh my god, yes.
My friend's calling me.
I am a winner. And I am done clocking in at 854.
Hey, my friend's waiting on me now.
It's alright, just go finish.
You might want to finish this for me so I don't have to keep him waiting. I'd rather not.
Alright, so this is my second set of primes for the month on this account. So let's get over to the cash shop and pick up those scrolls. And hopefully this time it will pass for... That would be a nice change, wouldn't it? Alright, yeah, so this number. Don't want to say anything else about it, though. I'm recording very late, so if I don't sound energetic, that's why. But, and I'm also feeling very defeated. And also, Maple just froze. Alright, there we go. Okay, let's get out of here. And Maple froze again. That's wonderful.
Eventually.
Okay, there we go. So annoying. Alright, so let's just pop it down here. So, plus 3 out of 9. Prot scroll, lucky day scroll. And yeah, let's just get on with it. You guys know this show. And I wish I could just do one clip without ever stuttering. Like, God. Alright, here we go. Oh my God, finally! You do not know how long I've waited for that. So, this character is done, finally. I'm very happy about that. Onwards to my Wild Hunter, and then the primes from Kelvin. And then I'll be done. Woohoo! Okay, I gotta give a sincere apology to you guys, because I know these episodes don't really make much sense. Mainly, it's only been this episode that I've actually tried to write out like a script on what's going to happen in the episode, and I didn't fulfill it. I wanted to get enough reward points on a few other accounts in the month of October so that I can get a few more clips of me trying to prime my heart, but I just couldn't do it. I got too busy. I got too lazy. I didn't want to do it. I seriously lost a lot of motivation trying to do this because it was just like really repetitive, and it just got really Korean grindy. And the worst part is that I don't even like record any of it. That's the problem. You guys always see like highlights or like random clips of me. It's never like conjunct or put together well enough. And I really apologize for that. And I really am trying my best to put out like good episodes. A good episode doesn't mean like I have to be successful or anything, right? It's more or less that I want to show you guys what is the road to max damage. That's basically the whole point of the series that I'm trying to make. I want to show you guys the actual process that it takes to get to max damage using mesos only. And I feel like this entire series, I've done none of that. This felt more like a Let's Play series to me, so I sincerely apologize for that. I hope you guys are still around for the next episode. I'm gonna try my best. I got busy with school as well, and let's face it, I have to value school over Maple. And sometimes when I get back from school after a long day, because some days I go from 9 to 8, like school days, and I don't get home till like 8:30, and then I don't get to get on my laptop until like 9:30, and then by that time I'm already like studying for tomorrow. So yeah, I'm sorry. And because of this, I completely missed the opportunity to make a whole episode dedicated to getting NX codes from people with mesos. I mean, I gotta show you my progress. This is the only fair way of showing you my road to max damage. So I gotta go to the cash shop and I gotta show you. And at the same time, I probably have to change my password and PIN after this. But if you look down here, this is how much NX I got. This is how much I actually managed to get. Do you know how much that is in mesos? Okay, granted, $25 was gifted to me as a birthday present from my good friend Welly. as well as a $10 donation and a birthday present from my friend Mark. So technically that's 220k. And the NX rates I got them at, that's over 20 bill. I could have shown you guys how I got over 20 bill. Even when I think about it, I didn't even know that I got over 20 bill until I actually looked at this amount. And I was like, oh my god, really? And as of right now, I can even get another 25k. And I feel so ashamed because, let me get out of here first. I just feel so ashamed because this would have been a perfect opportunity to show you guys this road to max damage. And I completely failed. And I'm sorry. So I hope you guys stick around. Like I said before, I'm going to try my best to upload a better episode. Not just like a bunch of random clips put together. That's because that's not what I want. I want someone to look back into these episodes and videos that I put out, and they will see like, oh, this guy actually did go from nothing, like 100k range, to 2 mil to capping without spending a single penny of his own money. I want to show you guys that. And anyways, enough of my blabbing. I really apologize. So what I've been doing recently, I've been merching. I guess I'll show you guys an episode of how I merch, but there's a fine gray area between that because, like, one, I don't want to show you guys how I get so much money because then everyone would just copy me, and then that would not benefit anybody because it's you guys are not learning how to make money. You're just blatantly copying a tactic that, when you do, oversaturates the market with such whatever thing I am doing to make money. I'm holding 500 mil right now. 3 bill is in the bank, and I did nothing to show you guys. I'm just, oh my god. But yeah, what else have I been doing? I've been doing a lot of Tower of Oz, as you guys saw from the earlier clips. I do it with my guild leader Gabe and my friend Terry. So we usually do it together. Oh, and we do it with Jun, eBay customer, but he's quitting, unfortunately. So, rest in peace. And what else have I been looting CRA. Calvin, if you guys remember from, like, many episodes before, he's been helping me every day, every week, in this road to max damage. And I haven't even given him, like, fair credit. Like, you see all this loot? Like, sure, part of... Like, these pro players give loot like it's Halloween candy. Speaking of which, happy Halloween, guys. This is... I'm recording this on Halloween. So, yeah, like, look at all this loot. All this loot was basically handed down to me by Calvin. And I've made no effort in trying to show you guys. So, yeah, I've been looting for Calvin. I've been finishing Helix for him every day. Calvin brings me to Hard Mag every week, and yeah, basically he's just carrying me at this point. And what sucks the most is that, once again, I'm ranting and I'm sorry, I just feel like I do this every episode, how I just make up excuses, but this needs to get out and done. So next episode I will actually have some sort of substance or core within it, and I don't know what it is right now, but I definitely will try and make the effort to doing so. So where was I? Oh yeah, so Kelvin takes me to Hard Mag every week. He takes me to CRA every week. He freaking lets me finish Helix for him every day. And I've been doing this for him. This has been going on for like months, and I have not said anything. So I feel like shit. But that being said though, I'm gonna end it on a somewhat good note. With my range increase since the last time I've actually tried to do something, because this, so far, the rest of the series is just basically NX. There is nothing I can actually do in this game that will actually help me with getting more range. I have everything I'm looking for. Everything that I can do with Messels, it's been done. I've scrolled all my Golux gear. I've spell traced my sword. I've gotten spell traced. Starforced everything and whatever. I even got a freaking godly emblem now. And what's left? I mean, all there's left is cubing. How else am I going to cube at the most efficient way possible? And the only efficient way to do it is NX. So therefore, the rest of the series is just basically me trying to get NX using Messels only. And this is why I was so frustrated, because this is the gray area that I knew was coming when I first started the series, that I was going to eventually have to use a butt ton of NX. And some people may watch this and be like, oh, so this guy's not legitimate anymore because he's actually just using other people's NX. And what I really hope to get is people looking, saying, oh, this guy managed to... Like, it's just mainly the process of getting the NX that I want to show you guys. And I don't know how long I've been ranting. I'm really sorry. But here's the thing. This clip is out of sequence. I have a... I'm going to show you the next clip. I've been practicing because I know eventually I will have to, you know, solo all the bosses. I plan to start practicing the CRA bosses and start planning to do hard mag myself, because eventually that's the point of getting to 2 mil, 2 mil. If you get to max damage, if you cap, but you don't do any of that, what's the point? What's the point of damage if you don't go for those things, right? So I've been practicing hard Golux, and I want to show you guys a clip, the entire battle of me killing it. So I hope you enjoy, and I hope you guys stick around for the next episode.